Marriage, love and relationship. Normally, love and relationship are considered as synonyms, but that is the greatest mistake. In the seed form, they are, but when seed begins to grow, you realize that they are separate. It becomes very difficult to understand if there is anything beyond love. What happens when you go beyond love? Love is light. Love is awareness. Love is understanding. In order to continue to live in the world, in order to relate to the people, you need an understanding. If you are going through the dark cave, you need light. If you are trying to wade through the intense darkness, you need light. Love is trust. It makes you fearless. So in order to go through the dark cave, you need light that can constantly guide your way, because the journey is all alone. Love is that light. Love is understanding. Love is awareness. It is because I have understood love. It is because when love is light for me, love is awareness, I am able to explore deep within the recesses of my being and share with you that may sound to you amazing or something beyond your expectation. But this is how it is. And when you reach that, you transcend all the finite boundaries of marriage, love, sex, all the dualities. We are involved in the duality of good and bad, sin and virtue, right and wrong. In the ultimate analysis, when you have attained to innocence, there is no sin and virtue. As a grown-up person, for you to walk naked or remain naked in front of people is considered as obscenity. But a child in his innocence can move naked and there is no obscenity in it, because child has attained to the state of innocence, and innocence is that state which is beyond right and wrong, good and bad, all the dualities. That is why when someone asks Jesus, who can enter the kingdom of thy father, he said, one who is childlike. He did not say one who is childish. Being childlike is a conscious effort. A child is born, the awareness has not yet grown. He is a new addition to the world. But as he begins to grow, to move along the path, the society, the parents, and all that impose their ideas, and there is conditioning. When you break the shackles of conditionings, all that society has imposed on you, and you come to a state beyond duality, that is the state of innocence, which has come out of understanding of the cosmic phenomena. Jesus is talking about that innocence, not the innocence of a child. That's why he says one who is childlike, not childish. There is a great difference between being childlike and childish. When you attain to that state, then there is nothing wrong, nothing virtue. There is no sin, no virtue, nothing right and wrong, good or bad. All dualities disappear. When dualities disappear, then you reach the state of transcendence. Then love becomes awareness, love becomes light. And in that state, you even go beyond sex. You are beyond sex means we either condemn sex or accept it. We remain involved in it or we renounce it. When you are neither condemning it nor accepting it, it is accepted as it is because it is your existential energy that you are born with. The only thing is this, you have to learn the process of transcending beyond it. You have got a raw piece of material that you cannot use. You are converting into a usable item. You bought the raw ingredients from this supermarket. You cannot consume these in their state as they are. You have to use different combinations to bring utility into it, that it becomes consumable, it becomes tasty and a delicious dish. So we have to learn the process how to transform that basic existential energy into a guiding force, a light, understanding or awareness. Then you are not condemning it, or you have totally accepted it as it is. Then too much involvement or too little is not the criteria. When there is need, you go into it. When you are hungry, you eat. But you are not going to obese. You eat when you are hungry, and when you are not hungry, you do not eat. Then there comes a temporary satiation, and along with that, a state of health comes onto you because you are moderate in your eating. This is what happens, and that state is known as Bhairav, as Lord Shiva, one who gave 112 techniques of meditation, the ancient most treatise on Tantra, known as Vigyan Bhairav Tantra. He is known as Bhairav, one who is in the body, yet still the body consciousness does not guide him. He is in the body, but he is not in the body. He is totally meditative, yet still he is in the world. He is in the world, but the world is not in him. He is constantly meditative. In the state of meditation, when the energy has transcended all the negative things, if they remain in the mind and continues to descend, they will defile you or the other whosoever hears it. If you are entertaining the ill thoughts against someone, you will remain upset with it. But if you do not want to remain upset with it and you go and speak it out, it will make the other upset or hurt it. So instead of that, he keeps it in a realm between the heart and the head. It does not defile the heart and the emotions that flow out of heart. And it does not defile your intellectual prowess or capability, so it remains between that. You know how and when to use it. The poison is neither affecting you nor affecting the others. But when love and relationship comes together, it brings anxiety, anguish and turmoil. This is how the journey begins. You have to understand this, and with the understanding of love, with the light of love, you can transcend this. One who has never been in anxiety, anguish and turmoil will never mature. Love is not a relationship. It cannot be. Certainly, it cannot be. Love is a state of being, the light, the awareness, the understanding. It is something that happens in your inner being. It is not observable to anyone. Something has happened within as if that you have tasted a very sweet fruit and you are unable to explain its taste. Words fail to express its taste. It is your inner happening. Although both love and relationship are seen as complementary, but really they are not. When love and relationship are embedded, many problems emerge. So these troubles, conflicts, anger, hatred, jealousy, possessiveness, domination, and thousand and one things comes with the relationship, and they are essential. Never shirk these, because if you have understanding and light of love, then these will give you maturity and will one day allow you to transcend beyond this. Naturally, therefore, you want to go into relationship. Also, it is natural whenever you enter into a relationship, a part of your mind always wants to avoid it. And there are reasons. The first reason, you are lonely within. You have not discovered the other shore within. If you are a male, you have not discovered the inner feminine aspect in you. If you are a female, then you have not discovered the other masculine aspect within you. You exist as one shore. And without the other shore, the river of life cannot flow. Your life is moving unconsciously because you have not discovered the other shore. You want to go into relationship. You have a desire and a need to go into relationship. But each relationship, when it begins, it brings problems, difficulties, challenges, miseries, conflicts. So another part of the mind says, why get into this trouble? And both are right. Alone you feel lonely. Alone you feel sad. Alone you feel life to be meaningless. Life's poetry arises only when you are together with someone. You have not discovered your aloneness. You have not understood the essence of it. And when you are together with someone, the problem begins. Life is meaningful only when you are in love. Otherwise, it seems meaningless. Mind wonders why go on living. For what and for whom? So one part of the mind aspires to love someone, be loved by someone, share your energy and celebrate this togetherness. Yet still there is another part of the mind that says to be careful. Each relationship turns out to be a problem, a sour one. Each relationship creates ugly scenes. Alone there is no problem. Only you are the problem. The other is not the problem. There is no other problem except you. However, with the other person, there are many problems, and then together both of you multiply these problems. One part of the mind goes on admonishing you from getting into this trouble. Alone at least you are peaceful. How can you be happy? But this peace is that of the graveyard. It is not a dancing piece. It is not a singing piece. Right. But at least you are peaceful. In relationship, who knows if happiness will happen or not. But one thing is certain. Peace will certainly be destroyed, mind says. This is why the conflict is there. It is in every human being. Each likes to love. And each likes to avoid. Now one has to understand it. One thing is that right now, if you avoid relationship, you will not grow. You will remain stuck. You will not grow. you will remain immature, because those challenges that relationship brings are necessary for inner growth. All these challenges are growth opportunities, not stumbling blocks. They appear as stumbling blocks, but you can convert these as opportunities. Never these consider as problems. These are tasks to be done. You have to do that homework, otherwise you will never grow. First, you discover the counterpart in you, and let the anima and animus merge into one another. Then you are neither male nor female. You can understand the two emotions. And when you transcend, again you are neither male nor female. Psychologically, emotionally, you have transcended both dualities. So these are the tasks that you have to do. You have to do the homework, otherwise you will never grow. Just think of a man who has never been in any trouble. He will never attain to maturity. One who has never been in anxiety, anguish, turmoil will never mature. He will remain childish. He will never mature. He will remain just as it is, and he will not have the backbone. Any small thing will destroy him and his composure. He will have no stamina to stand up against anything. So these troubles, conflicts, anger, hatred, jealousy, possessiveness, domination, and a thousand and one things come with the relationship in one package. They are great opportunities to be used to go beyond them. It is good. And through awareness, through the light of love that you have discovered within, you can transcend beyond these. Certainly one day will arrive and you will not need anyone, but there is no problem. Then you are so happy alone that there is no problem and no need for the other. There is no question of being related. I go to my work in the morning. When I return from home, I enter my room. There is no need for me to go out. I am happy all by myself. If someone comes, it's good. You come for something, your purpose is served, you go. Otherwise, there is no need for me to come out of the door, come out of the house. One day someone asked that I have not seen you for a couple of days. I told the person that you wake up when I am finished my day's work. I start my day very early, finish it, and when I am finished for the day. There is no need for me to go out of the house. Certainly one day will arrive when you will not need anyone. But then there is no problem. Then you are so happy alone that there is no problem at all. Otherwise, you do not know how to pass time, how to kill time. If television is not working, if phone is not working, either you are on phone or on watching the television shows. I have been given a gift of television by my daughter. I told her I don't need it, but she said, "How could you live without television?" Okay, if you want to give it to me, I have a piece of ornament. Now, my son is more concerned about getting it operated so that whenever he comes or anyone comes can watch the TV. But there is no cable, there is no need. Whatever things I want to watch, they are already on YouTube and you can stream it. So he had made the arrangement to get it streamed from YouTube on a bigger screen. Otherwise, I was watching those on my laptop, but he did it. It becomes very difficult for people to conceive how you could be alone and be not afraid, be not lonely. You recall the incident when Confucius decided to go and meet Lao Tse. He heard that Lao Tse is sitting in a cave on top of the mountain on a winter day. That alone sent quivers in his bones. He went to meet Lao Tse in the cave. He told his disciples, let him go alone. And when he comes, he will come and report what did the conversation went between him and Lao Tse. When he went inside the cave, he was horrified. There was no one. Lao Tse was sitting alone in meditation. He said, Lao Tse, I have come to talk to you. At this, Lao Tse said, then talk and go. He said, what about you? I have come for a dialogue. He said, there is no one here. I am not. I do not exist. I do not need to have a dialogue with you on any subject or matter because there is no confusion in me. If you have come to ask me something, ask and then go. If you have come for a dialogue, that there cannot be any dialogue. The dialogue can happen only between two people. But I am not a person. I am a presence. Can you talk to the presence? It is said that Buddha and Mahavir, they were contemporaries. They never met one another. Although they wandered in the same land that was known as in India, the state of Bihar, both lived in the northeastern part of the country. They never met one another. Then it happened. One day both of them stayed in the same guest house, but they never talked. But Buddha has to talk to Mahavir. Buddha knows the same thing that Mahavir knows. There is nothing that you can tell Buddha or Buddha can tell you. You may know many dishes, the other may know many dishes, so you can share your dishes, your recipe. But there is no other recipe that Buddha and Mahavir both do not know. They have reached to the same spot, same level of consciousness where there is oneness. How can there be a dialogue? Confucius got frightened. He said, but you are there and I have come all the way to have a dialogue with you. He said, you are mistaken, I am not. I am simply a presence, the mind is no more. And you cannot have a talk, a dialogue with the presence, because I do not need to talk anything. It is said, Confucius ran out of the cave. On a cold winter, snowy morning, he was perspiring. All he told his disciples, it is reported, that Lao Tse, that man is very dangerous. That man is very dangerous. Certainly the day will arrive when you will not need anyone. Then there is no problem. It is said Shiva, constantly in a state of meditation, and he is alone on the mountain, the highest peak, where he is sitting down in meditation. When it is said about Holy Prophet, he used to go to Mount Hir. Mount Hir is that state of highest consciousness when he is all alone, unconcerned about anything, but yet still he is not alone. He is meditative. He comes out of his, you cannot eat whole day. You cannot make love whole day. You made love, you come out and you are again gone into the rest or meditation. Then again you go and eat, you go and rest. The process goes on like this, but there is no problem. Then you are so happy alone that there is no problem alone. There is no question of being related. But right now, it will be harmful for you to avoid relationship. Plunge into them, and while young, go through all sorts of problematic situations. So by the time you become physically mature, you attain psychological maturity as well. But what about those who have already outgrown the age? Then you can go into your past relationships and relive them one by one. You have been living your life, married life, unconsciously so far. Start it from the beginning when it began, the day one. Every day during the state of meditation, unravel each page in you are going into each day as it progressed, the relationship progressed. You are going into that meditatively now. You have entered this unconsciously. Now you are watching it into retrospect, into a video form on your inner sky. Otherwise, what happens? People become physically mature, whereas psychologically they remain childish, and you will find them everywhere. Their face looks as if they are 50, and if you scratch the surface, you will find a 12-year-old child. Deep within, they remain psychologically immature. Inside, they are just stupid children. Just look at it when people engaged into day-to-day activities and how immature they are in their talks. So this is for you to decide. One thing is certain, maturity and growth comes through difficulties. I always prefer difficulties. It is difficulties and problems that give you the garb of maturity. Therefore, never avoid them. Whenever you find a difficulty, make it a challenge. Forget about everything else and jump onto the difficulty wholeheartedly and using it as a stumbling block, climb over it and you reach to the other shore. And to love a difficult person is one of the most beautiful experiences. Never find a person who has no difficulties. He will not be of any help.